The Happiest Diet in the World by Giulia Crouch is a book that delves into the relationship between food, dieting, and happiness. In a world rife with trendy diets and conflicting nutritional advice, Crouch takes a refreshing perspective on what it truly means to eat for joy and well-being. Rather than advocating for restrictive eating patterns, the book encourages readers to embrace a more balanced, pleasurable, and culturally rich approach to food. Crouch opens the book with a critique of the diet industry, which often promotes quick fixes and unhealthy patterns of eating that can lead to psychological distress and a negative relationship with food. She points out that dieting, in the traditional sense, often leads to a cycle of deprivation and guilt, which is counterproductive to the pursuit of genuine happiness and health. Crouch argues that a diet can only be successful if it is sustainable and enjoyable, emphasizing that food should be a source of pleasure, not a source of anxiety. The author draws on a variety of sources, from scientific studies to personal anecdotes, to support her claims. She explores the concept of happy eating, which is not just about the food on the plate, but also about the atmosphere, company, and the cultural significance of meals. Crouch takes inspiration from countries known for their healthy and happy populations, such as those in the Mediterranean region, where people embrace diets rich in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, lean proteins, and healthy fats, but also value the social and pleasurable aspects of eating. Through the book, Crouch examines the importance of balance and moderation in dieting. She stresses that no food should be off limits, as long as it is consumed in moderation and balanced with nutrient-rich foods. This idea resonates with the principles of intuitive eating, where individuals learn to trust their body's hunger and fullness cues, and mindful eating, where the focus is on savoring and enjoying food without distraction. Crouch also addresses the concept of comfort food and its role in our sense of well-being. She argues that while emotional eating can sometimes lead to unhealthy patterns, seeking comfort in food is a natural and often positive aspect of human experience. She encourages readers to find comfort in healthier food options and to recognize the difference between mindless emotional eating and finding solace in a nourishing meal. In one of the key sections of the book, Crouch provides practical advice on how to implement the ideals of the happiest diet into daily life. She suggests cooking at home more often to have control over ingredients and to enjoy the process of preparing food. She also recommends trying new recipes and cuisines to keep meals exciting and to broaden one's culinary horizons. Other tips include focusing on seasonal and local produce, which tend to be fresher and more flavorful, as well as better for the environment. Community and social connections are also an integral part of Crouch's happiest diet. She highlights the significance of shared meals and the role they play in fostering relationships and a sense of belonging. Eating with others, whether family or friends, can contribute to a more enjoyable and rewarding eating experience. Crouch encourages readers to revive the tradition of communal dining, not just for special occasions, but as a regular part of life. Another aspect of the happiest diet is the idea of food as a celebration of life. Crouch emphasizes the role that cultural traditions and festivities play in shaping our attitudes towards food. She encourages readers to partake in celebrations, to savor food during holidays and other special events without guilt, and to appreciate the deep connections between food, culture, and happiness. Physical health is not overlooked in the happiest diet in the world. Crouch acknowledges the importance of nutrition and its impact on our bodies and minds. She discusses the benefits of incorporating a variety of foods into one's diet to ensure an intake of essential vitamins and minerals. She also acknowledges the role of physical activity, not as a punitive measure to counteract food consumption, but as another source of joy and an important aspect of a balanced lifestyle. Towards the end of the book, Crouch confronts the challenges that many face when trying to change their eating habits. She provides strategies for overcoming obstacles such as time constraints, budget limitations, and ingrained food preferences. She emphasizes that change should be gradual and forgiving, allowing for setbacks without self-criticism. Finally, Crouch concludes by reiterating that the happiest diet is not about rigid eating rules or deprivation. It's about embracing food as a delicious and nourishing part of life, enjoying every bite, and fostering a joyful relationship with eating. By focusing on happiness as the ultimate goal of eating, rather than weight loss or adherence to strict dietary guidelines, Crouch presents a compelling case for a new, more joyful approach to what we eat. Overall, The Happiest Diet in the World is a celebration of food's role in our lives as a source of pleasure, comfort, and connection. Giulia Crouch's approachable and evidence-based insights provide a welcome contrast to the often punitive and joyless narrative surrounding dieting. Her book encourages readers to find happiness in eating well, to listen to their bodies, and to cherish the communal and cultural experiences that food can provide, ultimately advocating for a balanced, healthy, and happy way of life through our dietary choices. You can listen to the full audiobook for free by following the URL in the description.